This is part 21 of Azure tutorial. In this video, we'll discuss how to deploy a web application, specifically ASP.NET Web Forms application in Azure. It doesn't really matter if it's Web Forms, MVC, or .NET Core. The process is the same. You'll see how easy it is. With just a few clicks, in just a few minutes, you have your app up and running in the cloud. Now, this is the web application that we will be deploying in Azure. As you can see, it displays a list of inspirational codes. At the moment, this web application is running on my local machine. You can say that by looking at the URL in the address bar. This is the web form that displays the list of codes. At the moment, as you can see on this web form, we have a repeater. And if we take a look at the code behind file, we have a method here, getCodes. And it returns list of strings, that is, in our case, list of codes. So we have a variable here of type list of strings. And what we are doing is adding 5 codes to this list and then returning that list. And in the page load event, we are calling that method, which is going to return us the list of codes and setting that as the data source for the repeater and calling the data bind method. And for the repeater itself, we have an item template and an alternating item template. The only difference between these two templates is we are using different Bootstrap styling classes. For the item template, we are using alert success, and for the alternating item template, we are using alert danger. And that's the reason we see two different colors here. So, a pretty simple ASP.NET Web Forms application. In just a bit, we'll see how easy it is to deploy this web application in Azure using Azure App Service. Now, let's see what it takes to host this same web application in our own on-premise server. It involves a lot of things. First, we need a physical or a virtual server operating system like Windows or Linux must be installed. The server needs to be secured and configured. Install antivirus software, updates, and any patches. Configure firewall settings, etc. It's another big task for the infrastructure team. It's not just the initial setup, they have to maintain it too. To host a web application and make it available on the web, you need a web server like IIS, Tomcat, Nginx, etc. You need to install and configure the web server correctly, like security permissions, application pools, SSL settings, etc. The list goes on. On top of this, you install your web application and any dependencies it may have. Just imagine the number of people, the amount of time and effort it takes to have our app up and running in our own on-premise server. Now, before we deploy our web application in Azure, let's quickly hop over to the Azure portal and let me click on resource groups. As you can see, we don't have any resource groups. I've deleted everything that we have in the Azure portal to keep our slate clean. We are going to deploy our web application to Azure right from within Visual Studio. So in the Solution Explorer, right-click on your web application project name and then select this option from the context menu, Publish. On this Publish window, select Azure and click Next. Here, select Azure App Service because it is the Azure App Service we want to deploy our web application to, and then click Next. From the drop-down list here, select your Azure subscription, and then we want to deploy our app to an app service instance in Azure. In the Azure portal, we deleted everything, so we don't have an app service instance already. So let's create a new app service instance by clicking on this plus sign. On this Create App Service window, we first need to provide a name for the app service. And the name we provide here is important because it is this name that's going to determine the URL that we will be using to access our web application. Now, to keep it unique, I'm going to name it GoodVenkatQuotes. So the URL to access our web application now will be GoodVenkatQuotes.azurewebsites.net. We'll see that in just a bit. If you want to, you can use your own custom domain, maybe something like inspirationalquotes.com. We'll discuss how to do that in our upcoming videos. Next, select your subscription from this drop-down list and then a resource group. We are creating a new resource group here. I'm going to leave the default name and then a hosting plan. We want to use a free hosting plan to host our web application. We want to start free and then add features as required. So to select a free hosting plan, click on this new button, provide a name for the hosting plan. Let's leave the default name and then a location. Let's select East US region. Finally, size. It is the size that determines what we pay and what we get. This size actually corresponds to Azure pricing tiers. In our previous videos in this series, we discussed in detail app service plans, pricing tiers, including how to create them in Azure portal. The only difference now is we are creating them right from within Visual Studio while we are deploying the app, but the concept is still the same. Now, we don't want to pay anything to host a web application. We want to start free. So let's select the free pricing tier and then click OK. On this window, click Create. Right now, our app service and app service plan with the selected pricing tier are being created in Azure. Finally, click Finish. We are almost there. At the moment, we are on this publish window, and we can see the summary here. This is the URL we use to access our website, and this resource group is already created in Azure. It is in this resource group we have both our app service and app service plan already created. Now, all that is left to do is deploy this website to this app service in Azure. For that to happen, all we need to do is push this publish button. There we go. We have our code deployed and our app is up and running in the cloud. Take a look at the URL in the address bar. Now, take a look at Azure portal. We have our codes resource group created, and if we navigate to it, both our app service and app service plan are present here. And if we navigate to the app service plan, at the moment, we are on the overview blade. Let's go to apps. We see our Kud Venkat Codes app deployed in this plan. Let's click on scale up. We have pricing tiers here. And if you remember, within Visual Studio, we selected the free pricing tier, and that is what is selected by default. If we want more features, for example, something like custom domains or SSL bindings, we select the appropriate pricing tier and then click apply. For now, let's just stick to this free pricing tier. At the moment, the data for our web application, in this case, Codes data is hard-coded within the web page itself. But what if this data has to come from a database? The point is how to deploy a web application that has a dependency on a database, like SQL Server, for example. We'll discuss how to do exactly that in our next video. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.